last set because I was playing a space animal.
Well, now we can watch. Roy's pretty much a spacey, just no shine and he's got a sword.
It's Roy versus Tiny Roy.
That's true, because he's got the detail that pops up. And Roy can actually go off stage, because he's got a good recovery. That's true.
I actually think that both these characters have unedgeguardable recoveries.
That's true.
Yeah.
I mean, you can kind of just hold ledge against Roy as long as you're invincible.
It doesn't work. I've tried it. He got lucky.
Yeah,
he has SD'd, actually.
Damn. I mean, Juan sucks.
So, Zane, what do you know about this matchup, if anything?
I know that one's a little Roy, and then one's a big boy Roy.
Okay, that's good.
And he's the boy.
Please tell me more.
Can I tell you about when I went to Red Robin?
You can.
I went to Red Robin with my friend Brad, and we noticed the...
What's your friend's name?
Brad. Not Bradley Gherkin. You know that gherkin actually means pickle, and like in Europe they call pickles gherkins.
I didn't know, and now I do, and I'm a better man for it.
You should go to like, hey, pickle, when you see Brad.
This is better. Call him Brad Pickle?
Yeah, call him Brad Pickle. Bradley Pickles.
Brad.
So I went to Red Robin.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
you know
yeah,
how they have the Red Robin as the mascot?
Yes.
Well, I sat down with my friend, and he was like, it doesn't even really look like a robin.
Right.
So he tried to tell me it was a woodpecker, and I said, no, it's not a woodpecker, it's obviously a rooster. And the waitress came by, and this entire time we were at Red Robin, we were trying to like debate what kind of bird this was.
Alright.
So I ended up calling it everything from like a rooster to a toucan to like a flamingo.
So you were just throwing out birds at that point.
Yeah, because it's not a robin, because this is my... Okay, so robins are naturally red, right? Are you a robin man?
I'm robins. Not a robin man.
I feel like, I'm pretty sure that robins are naturally red. So to call it red
that
robin...
That sounds right.
It sounds right. To call a robin red is really redundant.
It kind of is.
So why
maybe
would you...
maybe you're wrong then.
It wouldn't, like, it wouldn't
maybe
technically be wrong.
Maybe naturally red. Maybe it's just, like, common.
But I think they are red, you know?
Yeah, I can't
so
argue
it's just
it.
It's just redundant, even if it
I'm
is common.
I'm just saying keep an open mind.
It's redundant to call them red.
Yeah.
So...
if they are naturally red.
So... we argued about what kind of bird this was because it wasn't a robin.
Like
it wasn't.
You can't edgeguard that recovery.
We deduced it wasn't a rooster.
Deducer?
We thought maybe it was. We thought maybe it was a woodpecker, but we weren't sure.
Yeah.
And then we started arguing about like what color of red it was, like what shade of red.
Now that sounds like a waste. It's obviously
no.
Scarlet red.
No, we thought it was. He thought it was crimson. He thought it was salmon, and I said, "No, you fucking idiot! It's not salmon. If it's a bird, not a fish."
Yeah. Right.
And so as we're getting up, by the way, because the waitress, like, she heard all of this. And as we're getting up, after she gives us, like, after we're, like, starting to leave,
yeah.
I get up and I say to him, I swear to God, every time we come here, you have to say it's a fucking ostrich. And we left on that note.
Wow. That's quite a story.
I can't stand Red Robin now.
You can't what?
I can't stand Red Robin now.
Now you can't? You just
now I just
it just bothers you too much?
No, because
focus on their good food.
It's obviously a scarlet woodpecker in the end.
I don't know about obviously, but it's
pretty obvious.
You're
it's like a compressed.
It's at least a safe option to call it.
It's
that.
It's like a compressed ostrich if you look at it.
Compressed?
Because ostriches are so tall, so they just gotta like vertically compress it.
Okay.
You know how, like, panthers aren't that tall, but the Pink Panther is, like, super big and tall.
It's more tall than big.
Yeah, but I guess
they're one and the
same. They're not bipedal.
That is, I don't know why that, like, catches people off guard so often. The walk past forward smash.
That's the Zach Maitland. Did you know that? That is actually the Zach Maitland.
That's the Zach Maitland. He invented it.
Yeah, I don't know. I do that a lot, too. And, like, it just catches people
cool.
off guard. It is a pretty common option, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean...
Do you fall for
it
yourself?
It seems like... not really. It seems like Roy has a lot... He has enough tools that he doesn't need to throw out something like that.
I feel like... Wait, so he doesn't want, like... Does he walk behind him, like, in shields? Was he doing it?
What's that?
Did he, like, walk through shield and then do it?
Yeah,
I feel like Yono would just jump out of shield and nair him. But did he not?
He didn't. He just sat in shield, and then he unshielded and got hit.
Oh, what a buster.
I think that's what happened.
You should have, cause it.
Oh, you, could he have F smash there?
Yono's really good at doing just like jump out of shield and staying out in aerial. Cause like a lot of people like try to challenge shield or like pressure it.
Yeah.
He just jumps out and he's like, no, just nair.
See, because I play Fox. I always forget about the very simple, good option, if you have a fast enough aerial, of just aerialing out of shield.
Yeah. But no, you gotta shine out of shield.
Yeah, and then I get hit because it's not big enough. It's big, don't get me wrong. It's not big enough. Oh my god, Food just almost bodied.
Food's going ape shit right now.
Yeah, beaten lane. Every stock? Oh my god.
That sucks.
That's like me in Melee today.
How'd you do in Melee?
I didn't do too well.
That's a shame.
I'm not too upset about how I played, but I'm upset with
you could have just done a little bit better, maybe.
Yeah, just a little better would have got me a lot further. But it doesn't matter, I'm fun. That's what's important.
Jonas. I don't know, Wani may take this. Jonas took game one. I know he's got him off stage, but he's got the stock lead.
This matchup seems really intense.
It looks like a lot of fun too.
Aren't they both roughly around the same fall speed?
Kind of
like
so.
Pseudo fast followers.
Yeah, they're both sort of
like
fast followers.
Not quite. Is Wolf in this category, or is Wolf in like a category of his own right before you get to Spaceys and Falcon?
I think Wolf is like, I think he's right before the actual Spaceys.
Okay.
The fall speed, or maybe he might be a Spacey. I don't know.
Well, isn't Falcon in that category too? But he's heavy.
Falcon's a pseudo fast follower.
He's a pseudo fast follower. Oh. Okay.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
I thought he, for some reason, I thought he like.
Is it pseudo?
I don't want to say it.
Pseudo, like tomato, tomato. Is it?
Maybe.
That, like,
I've never heard pseudo before, but I kind of like it more. It's like.
Yeah, it rolls off your tongue.
It's
better.
Very like Oriental sounding.
Yes, pseudo.
It's nice. It's elegant. I wonder if I should play.
It is very elegant.
This is so close. Just like the game.
I know.
Just like the game.
These guys are like the. These guys are like. Not good buds. They're good buds. So it is very close. That was a really good set, though. Even though we talked about the Robin most of the time.
Why did Yona look so like upset after that? Like he's
just
killing his own.
He's pissed off that he won.
He's killing his own character.
They looked at, like, cause like Yona's like the Seth Rogen and Juan's like the Jonah Hill. You know, they even look like him.
Do they?
That's like Seth Rogen killing Jonah Hill. You don't.
Seth Rogen would never want to do that. But if he were forced to, he would, right?
Yeah. Definitely.
Why is my name spelled with a lowercase e?
I don't know. Tell him to chew him out right now.
I don't want to chew him out.
Hey, Scrub. 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 He can't even hear me.
Can't even hear you.